Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9070 relay output. I have here an IC697MDL940 and I have it in an IC697CHS750 5 slot rack. And I'm using, the processor is an IC697CPX772. And the power supply is IC697PWR711. So now on the other side of what you can't really see here, I'm going to jump over to Prophecy Machine Edition. And I'm going to open up the test file I have, which is the same exact physical configuration you see here in rack 0 or main rack. Slot number 2, I have an MDL940 configured. So what I've done is I've gotten the processor into run mode. I'll basically go through that real quick. I go to target, online commands, clear, erase controller fault and IO table because this is a new request, a new configuration, and then I hit download and run once those are cleared. And I'm just downloading configuration and logic, just the first two options when it asks you what you want to download. And then, of course, it's going to allow you to enable the outputs, which we've got going right here. All right. So back to the MDL940. I have a pre-wired terminal fixture here for test purpose. And what I've done is I have wires that all jump to all these different terminals. The different terminals I'm using simply is anything that says V for voltage. So 2, 5, 8, 11, 15, and so on. So anything that says voltage, you need to go to the corresponding screw, or I should point out down here 32 and 33 screws, 39 and 40. There's a pair there. So you got to make sure that these are all connected. And when they are all connected, what I like to do is I have a 24 volt DC, because what you're able to do here is 24 to 240 volt AC or 5 to 125 volt DC. So I have here this test fixture. It's a 24 volt power supply. It's enough so that when I turn on each of the different relays, I'm able to test them. And I've got the positive lead connected to terminal 40. You could choose any of the terminals that have voltage going to it. I just choose to do terminal 40 so that I have positive lead powering all of these that are interconnected to where it says voltage. All right. And then the negative lead is loose. All right. So what we're going to do there is I've got a test fixture here, which is a 24 volt automobile light bulbs with probes. And when it does come time for test after I've turned them all on, I'm going to connect the negative lead from the lights to the negative lead from the power supply. And then the positive lead, and I'm just going to give you a little test here, is going to test all the different terminals once they've been turned on. So, okay. Another thing I want to point out, and you need to be careful about this, is normally open and normally closed. So you have two channel A1. One of them is normally open, which is what's on right now, and the other one is normally closed. So that means that number one, when these are not turned on, when these outputs are not turned on, then the normally open should not work. So let me give you an example of that really quick, because I don't want you to misdiagnose your unit. Normally open A1 is terminal screw number one, which is right here, top right, as it's indicated. This should not work if this is working properly. So I'm going to go through and test all my normally opened and all my normally closed. Normally closed is screw number three, the next one down. So that should turn on because it's normally closed. Terminal four, normally open. Terminal 6, just below that, normally closed, and that's on. Right? A3, 7, normally open, that's not on. A3, normally closed, number 9, pardon me, That's on. Okay. Normally, open A4, screw number 10. Number 12, normally closed. Number 14, normally open, that's just below 12. 16, normally closed. 17, these 16 and 17 are correspond to the screws, normally open. 19, normally closed, this should turn on. Number 20, on the left-hand side, normally open. 22, normally closed. 23, on the other side, right side, normally open. 25, normally closed. Then we skip a couple here, and then we're into the C's, C1 through 4. 28, normally open. 29, normally open. 30, normally open. 31, normally open. So then when we turn these on, they should, when we turn these to the on position and you hear the click and it indicates here that they're on, we should be able to get a light on like that. All right, and then the other four is 35, 36, 37, 38, all normally open. All right, so I'm gonna go into my output table so we can test the rest. Go under default tables, percent Q or output. I have mine configured at address location starting number 1, so you should hear a click, and there should also be a light that comes on. Numerals 1 through 4. Okay, 16. We have 16 channels altogether. It might be difficult to see this, but it's A1 through A4, B1 through B4, C1 through C4, D1 through D4. All right. So let's start with our category at the top. Again, negative lead from the lights, negative lead from the power supply. All right. So I can make a complete circuit. And we're going to only touch the normally open. These are the ones that we weren't able to do. Well, actually, we're going to do both. So normally open, number 1, should be on. Right, and then terminal number 3, normally closed, should be off because the switch has changed. Terminal number 4, normally open, is now closed. Number 6, normally closed, so that should be off. 7, should be on. Number 9, normally closed, that should be off. 10, right here, normally open. So far, so good. 12, normally closed. That shouldn't be working, that's right. Number 14, number 14 is here, normally open. It's now a closed circuit. 16, normally closed, that's off. 17, normally open. Okay. 19, normally closed, so that's off. 20, normally open. 22, normally closed. 23, normally open. 25, normally closed. Now we're going to get into these where all four circuits should be on because they're typically or normally open. We've just closed them as we heard the circuits closing. All right, so 28 on, 29 on, 30 on, 31 on. That's right. Then we're going to go to 35, 36, 37, 38, and all normally open. Now they should be closed. Closed, 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 closed. So just to reiterate one last time, this can be confusing with the normally open, normally closed, and sometimes it gets misdiagnosed, and then they end up here, and there's really nothing wrong with them. Just so to clarify, normally open means that when these circuits are off, they're not energized. Normally closed means that when these circuits are all off, they are energized and they should be providing power. Just keep that in mind. Otherwise, if you're not getting a light or you're not hearing the relays in the back here click on, or if you hear them click on but you don't have any power, or if all those work and you do have power but when you go to shut it off it won't shut off, it sticks on, that's also no good. Any of those things is a you know, catastrophic problem with the device, and it's something that we can easily repair here. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured units. So if that's something that interests you and you need, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.